What is going on, everybody? This is Super Nintendo Mike here, and welcome to Borderlands, the pre-sequel. I've been waiting a really long time for this game. I'm really tired. I don't usually play games this early, but whatever. I'm really tired, so hopefully the commentary is okay. Set all my settings, 1080p, everything is maxed out. Hopefully this is worth it over the Evil Within. So I probably could do matchmaking if I really wanted to, but I want to claim all the XP for myself. So, I mean, for my first experience with this game, I just want to play it by myself. So, I will be playing with other people, but I'm not going to talk into reasons and such. So let's start a new network options. Play alone. Alright, let's start a new game. I'm recording this in 720p. I'm going to be recording for an hour straight, then I'm going to stop recording, go to bed, and then pick it up at, like, whenever I wake up. So, here, the first day, Tuesday, October 14th, you're going to see an hour of content, probably split into two or three videos. So, here we go. And hopefully subtitles are on. I mean, they better be.
Got some explaining to do, Tiger. Trained from childhood as an Atlas assassin with over 1,000 successful jobs to your name. Damn near killed my two best men before they brought you in.
She said we're her best men. That makes me feel good.
Ow. Here's how it is, Athena. I'm gonna ask you a single question, and if I don't like your answer, you will die. Aim at the prisoner. Now, I will ask you this only once. Why?
That is a long story. After the fall of General Knox, I wandered Pandora as a hired gun. One day, I received a job offer from a low-level Hyperion programmer. Come to the moon, it said. Hunt a vault, be a hero. I didn't trust Hyperion, but I was too hungry to pass up a paying job.
And what did you find?
Violence, insanity, and a hero.
Thank you.
If the Lost Legion hadn't ambushed Helios Station, everything might have gone a different way.
Alright, so that's an interesting intro. Didn't expect it to be like that. So there are four classes: Athena the Gladiator,
let's go to war,
Wilhelm the Enforcer,
bring in the law,
Nisha the Lawbringer, and Claptrack is Fragtrap. I was thinking of doing Claptrap, but it seems as though Athena is the main character, and I kind of wanted to play as her. With her shield and everything, it seems really cool. She seems more like the commando to me.
It is on.
He seems like the berserker in a way, and she seems like
defend and protect.
An assassin. But I'm gonna go with Athena. So I'm assuming the DLC gives you different skins. But I'm just gonna go default everything. You can change the head. Looks pretty cool, but I'm just gonna stick everything default, so let's go. Very interesting to see how the story goes. The story of this game really makes or breaks it.
Hello, Vault Hunter, and thank you for answering Hyperion's.
Look who it is.
Unfortunately, the Helios space station is currently under attack by insane Dawn military forces. Please take this echo device. Now follow me. I can take you to your contract.
Reward with one items. Okay, badass ranks from the previous game. So if you're not familiar with Borderlands 2, you basically, this is the same user interface because 2K Australia got the same dev kit as Borderlands 2. So these tokens you basically get for getting a certain amount of kills, and you can redeem them to increase your statistics. So I got 12 of them right away for some reason. I don't think that's to do with pre-order. That'd be kind of okay-ish. So I'm going to go with gun damage. Recharge delay, that's important. I'm going to do that twice. Shield capacity. Gun accuracy. The rate, reload speed, maximum health, recoil reduction, go accuracy again, recharge again, I guess, and shield recharge rate. Okay. It looks as though we're gonna start off with a really weak assault rifle and a pistol. This consumes 3 ammo per shot, but does a lot more damage. And this, but this is electric, so. And we have a personal item. So I have to configure my settings. Hopefully the recording turns out well, because Borderlands, I tried recording two practice recordings and it turned out very strange. I think I keep it at 7. So hopefully the recording turns out alright. Alright. So we don't have our ability yet, because we're not in outer space. And we get thrown into enemies right away. Oh no, they're good guys, never mind. So we're just collecting ammo, it seems like. They're just introducing you to all the mechanics and everything. So apparently I have to get the Handsome Jack. But I'm gonna loot first. Now I've actually tried recording Borderlands 2. I felt very uncomfortable doing it, so I was very familiar with the game, and so this is gonna be completely blind. So I think it's gonna be much more interesting. And if these first episodes are bad, I apologize. It's just Borderlands. Very awkward to record. I mean, I'm stuttering a little bit, but hopefully the recording is okay. Okay, area waypoint. It's basically in every game. Yeah, the game seems a little shaky, but it shouldn't be too much of a problem. Hopefully. Alright. Really not much going on right now, we're just killing some enemies. It looks like. Try out this pistol. Ooh! Nice. Get that shock damage, you get an elemental weapon right away. There's, I think, 4 of them. There's Skag, there's, which is the poison, and there's the one that gets rid of rust. There's electric, and then there's fire. But this pistol, not bad. But hopefully the game is stuttering just because of this area, I'm hoping, when we were running.
The Lost Legion must have killed this one. People think robots can't feel pain, but we actually feel it in slow motion, with great intensity.
I would rather listen to Claptrap than play as him, to be honest.
This is Athena, reporting in.
And every character has their own story description, so they're really pushing to make this game replayable, unlike Borderlands 2. Which, you did have different storylines, but they're... What they're throwing at you with this game is that there's gonna be different commentary when you play the second time through. Tina from Borderlands 2 DLC will be commentating. We're basically dealing with regular Borderlands combat where we can't go in the air, but what's interesting about this game is that you can float due to the zero gravity, but we're not experiencing that yet. But when we do, it's gonna be much easier to dodge bullets, and I think this game, even though it's intended to play with people, it's gonna be a lot easier playing by yourself, which is preferably what I like to do in RPGs, playing the first time. Second time through games, I like to play with other people, which is what I did with Borderlands and Borderlands 2. I didn't remember the first Borderlands was local or online co-op. Oh, okay. losing health. It's not good. I'm doing pretty bad. Why am I doing so bad? There we go. This pistol must be really bad or something, I don't know. I'm getting shot from behind? Oh. Now we got grenades. Alright, sorry I'm just being quiet. It's just that it's not really too exciting before. It'll definitely pick up. But this recording is definitely smoother-ish than recording Borderlands 2. Hopefully they fix some issues there.
You wanna wait? You're busy? That's cool. I'll just bleed over here internally for a while. Here, it's a super fun way to pass the time, but yeah, don't mind me. Just the guy who hired ya. Sorry, am I being passive-aggressive? My bad. That must be a symptom of almost dying, but no, I'm sure you've got a lot of important stuff to do. I'll just sit over here and try to keep my internal organs from rupturing. Make a day of it.
We got some weapons. Might as well take them all, but I think I'm gonna stick with this one. Yeah, we can't even use any of those yet. Okay, pick up or purchase 10 weapons. Yeah, you get the skill points, the badass points, ranks. Whoops. See, even I don't know an experienced Borderlands player. Forget things. Okay, looks like this is our way through. Need claptrap? Oh no, it's in the middle, never mind. I didn't pay attention to the radar. It's right here. Have to go to Jack. Then we probably go out that way. She's got some weird thumbs. Oh, we get to revive him? That's interesting. Ooh, leveled up, sweet. That was quick. And we're not gonna get our ability until level 5, I think. So.
Actually, look, these crazy bastards attacked Helio Station right out of our center for you guys. If we can drive them off, we'll be free to go after that vault on the moon's surface.
Okay. All right, looks like you got a shield. Pretty self-explanatory. Yeah, we have to wait until level 5. Yeah, I'm pretty sure.
It'll eat bullets until it depletes. When it does, you gotta hide and give it time to recharge. Hey, just let me activate the defense controls. In a few seconds, we'll have turrets, force fields, laser wires. These assholes won't know what hit them.
Critical failure.
It's interesting that you get to play alongside Jack, it seems like, in the beginning.
What? How?
Jamming signal originates from Elvin, Pandora's
moon. Oh, crap. Kill the turrets! Kill the turrets!
Yada, yada, yada. Your shields recharge. Basic stuff. Should be kind of expected. But Jack isn't doing anything as those turrets.
This day gets better and better. Alright, plan B. We can't take Helios back. We need to evacuate. Escape ships are this way.
Okay.
We must take this ground.
Who's that woman?
I don't know, she leads these.
Let me loot.
I don't know, but the first person to shoot her in the head gets a high five in a turbo mansion.
Yeah, it's interesting. I like it that when you're too far away from a character, you can actually hear them over radio communication, which is pretty cool. And it's actually pretty clear, too, surprisingly.